Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding the monetary policy review of the RBI. Now in this class I will not be decoding the lead editorial, that is friendship is a flowing river, because already I have done editorial decode on the topic of Indian-Bangladesh relationship. So if you are interested in watching that, you can watch yesterday's class. Now what is meant by monetary policy? A monetary policy is the policy of the central bank of any nation. Central bank of any nation, by which it decides that how the central bank is going to lend to the banks. So what would be the relationship between the central bank, that is the RBI, and the other banks? How would they be exchanging the money? Now the rate of exchange of money between the banks and the central banks will actually decide about how these banks, they will be lending to the customers. Now to the customers means to the corporate class. So it is the exchange rate, it is the, like the bank rate will decide at how much rate they will be lending. Rate in terms of repo rate and reverse repo rate. So all such changes, they have an effect on the economy. Effect in terms of what would be the inflation like, how the inflation should be tamed, how the economic activity should be warmed up, how the economic activity in an economy should be intensified. So all this is carried out through the monetary policy. So monetary policy primarily plays a very important role. Now when it comes to India, now India has brought about a big change how this monetary policy is conducted. Earlier monetary policy used to be the sole responsibility of the Central Bank of India, that is the RBI. But the new dispensation, the new government has reduced the autonomy of the central bank. Now it has set up MPC, Monetary Policy Committee. Now it is the MPC that basically decides about what kind of rates and at what rates the central bank would be lending to the banks. What is going to be the reverse repo rate? What is going to be the repo rate? What is going to be the bank rate? And what is going to be the cash reserve rate ratio? So all these things are decided primarily by the Monetary Policy Committee. Now the recently Monetary Policy Committee, it has increased the lending rate by few points. Now first of all we need to understand why the rates has been increased. Now the rates have been increased because as per the mandate given to the MPC, it was automatized that the MPC would be achieving about 4% of the inflation rate. But in the current economic scenario, what we are witnessing is that the inflation has risen to the level of 5%. So in order to basically contain inflation, in order to restrain inflation, the Monetary Policy Committee, what it has done, it wanted to withdraw, it wanted to reduce, it wanted to evaporate the intense liquidity that is currently existing in the economy. Now what is the relationship between the liquidity of the money and the inflation? And why RBI is worried about this liquidity? Now liquidity directly results in inflation. Now liquidity means that there is more money available in the economy. Now when more money will be available in the economy, it will be changing the less number of the goods that are existing in the economy. So by enhancing the rates, what RBI wants is that the more number of people should actually be depositing their amount in the banks, in the saving accounts. More number of people are pushed into that they should be not spending, They should not be having the money in their hands. Rather, more money should be with the banks. This is the purpose. See, whenever a central bank will be targeting inflation thing, it will have to sacrifice one thing. And what is that one thing? That one thing is the growth of the economy. That one thing is the lending to the corporate class. Because at the higher rates, the corporate class will not be ready to buy credit from the banks. So, jo corporate class hai, jab bahut zyada lending rate badh jata hai, us scenario mein corporate class paise bank se nahi leta hai. So, this also has an effect on the growth of the economy. And when the growth of the economy actually reduces, there are chances that the inflation might rise to a higher level. So, a balance needs to be maintained between an optimum inflationary level and at the rate at which the banks would be lending to the corporate class. So, this equation, this balance is not that easy. Because if you will reduce the banking rate, it might actually again result in increase in inflation. So, neither the one end of the spectrum will be yielding result, and nor the other end of the spectrum will be yielding the result. Neither too high of the lending rate will yield the result, neither too less of the lending rate will yield the result. Neither too higher inflation is good for the economy, nor too lower inflation is good for the economy. Now, when it comes to this monetary policy review of this quarter, the RBI, it has passed a message to the government that the government should not be coming out with populistic measures like wavering the farm loans, because if such loans will be waived off, it will send a very wrong signal to the corporate class. It will actually develop a wrong ethic in terms of returning the money to the banks, and it will have repercussions on the NPAs. And already India's NPAs, they have actually really risen very high. So this affects the health of the Indian economy. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact me at 84594-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.